heart and in my mind.
Yo.
My part of today was an experience with a lady who three of us actually tried to actually let her know what we were doing, outreach to her, and pray to her, pump her gas, and she just continuously said no, no, no. She actually got out, pumped her own gas, paid for it, and at the very end, she actually came to us wanting prayer for diverticulitis. So she is very ill, and I think maybe she was just afraid at first to ask for the prayer, didn't know us, but then at the very end was so thankful, and we all prayed for her, and we hope that she does better, and her name is Dot.
The gas buy down today was awesome. There's a lot of people who just were like, I had no idea that you guys were here in the community. I want to come check you out. It's great to see a church out just caring about their people. And then we had a few people who had just moved here from New York and just all kinds of different places hugging us, just feeling welcome and, you know, just overall that sense of community. And that's part of what we were trying to accomplish and just giving back. So it was really cool.
Well, you know, today for me was really what being a part of a church and my faith is all about, the opportunity to practically and to practically show the love of God to, you know, to the community in a way that we all kind of understand. Who wouldn't want, you know, some money off the gas tank? So this is a great thing, great for our church, and proud to have been involved. We look forward to doing more of these things with our church.
Vehicle and he didn't want to talk to anybody, he just wanted to pump his gas, so we did that, and he said he was coming back, so me and Jessica said, come back, pump four, we're the best, and he came back right to our line, and I knew that we had him, we had his heart, so we talked to him, and I asked him if he wanted to pray, and he seemed hesitant, but he opened my world to be able to pray for others, and I hope that he took something from today.
Awesome.
So pray for Kurt.
Great.
My take for today was how awesome it was to watch the people from Radiant Church be the hands and feet of Jesus Christ. It was so exciting to see the joy of the Lord on people, to see them stretching themselves, to see them doing things that they probably don't do, haven't done, and may not ever do again, but to see them just being the hands and feet of Christ, and to seeing the response of the people, and how awesome it was that people thought that this was the most amazing way to reach the community. What a great outreach event. More and more people said that, and they just thought that every church should be doing this. So yay Radiant, and yay God.
Awesome.
I don't know what my best moment was, but I'll tell you one thing, this thing was awesome. This thing was awesome. It was positive all the way around. I'm still energized over it, and that's about all I got to say, because we got to keep doing this. Because it's just a wonderful thing, and it was blowing people's minds, and we're going to see some people at our church because of it, for the right reasons.
Awesome.
Thank you very much. We love you.
Awesome. Hey, hi everybody. Tom here. I had the privilege and honor to be a leader of this event, and man, this was exceeded expectations. How about that? So God was present from the beginning to the end. In fact, He kind of backed me up in the planning. And it was just awesome. It's a stretching event, and I want to encourage the body to stretch, to get out of your comfort box. Big and powerful things happen here, and we can't underestimate the power of our contribution to making God present in this world that we live in. And so I also want to say thanks to the babysitters out there, because they did an incredible job with about one day notice, and I'm so thankful for them. And God, this is just the beginning, and our body is getting ready to move and stretch in new ways that's never been done before. And I hope you're a part of the next one. Thanks.